Doki Doki After School is a Doki Doki Literature Club fan month. It's not affiliated in any way with Team Salvato. Hey, look, they actually knew had the common sense to split any from way. Thank you for bothering to edit the default message. It is designed to be played only after the official game has been completed and contains the spoilers for the official game. Game files for Doki Doki Literature Club are required to play this mod and can be downloaded for free at blah 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 or on Steam. Additionally, After School contains offensive language, sexually charged dialogue, portrayals of mental illness, and adult situations. By playing After School, you agree that you've completed Doki Doki Literature Club and consent to viewing potentially distressing content. Well, at least they're up front about it. Not official fan creation, completed themes a while. Yeah. Here we are! Doki Doki After School Demo. We'll start as I always do. Bump it up that text speed. Get up there, you. Alright. There's no sounds. Let's enter our name. I'm Hallie. Thanks for noticing. It's Wednesday, my dudes. God, I am so tired. The past 9 hours have been absolute hell. There's nothing quite like constant shelf stocking, sales, and beratement. At least my shift is over. I exit the mall and take a deep breath. The hot afternoon sun has since dwindled into a relatively cool early evening. It's only the middle of the week, and yet it's so warm. Seems like it'll be a nice night anyway. Not that I'll really get to enjoy it. I still need to unpack a few things. Been putting that off for a while. Dishes, laundry, searching for job listings. My brain feels like mud from it all. At least at work, the day goes by quickly. I can focus on one thing at a time. Ironically enough, going home is the worst part. My energy is completely gone and my stomach is growling. I need food and a coffee. I go to the restaurant near my apartment, but I really need to lay off the fast food. Besides, I really only have enough for some coffee and maybe a cookie. I start my walk home. Maybe I'll run into a cafe or something. Wouldn't cafe prices be higher? The city gets kind of quiet around this time. I'm not sure why. People having dinner, I suppose. I've been eating at odd hours lately. Whenever I get off of work, mostly. A flickering sign catches my attention. A bistro of some kind. Excellent. I pass by here on my way to work, but I've never actually been inside. Guess now is as good a time as any. Thankfully, it's about as deserted as the city is. One or two customers are hanging out, about, drinks in hand. One appears to be focusing on a laptop. I make my order and take a seat at a nearby table. Black coffee with a drop of cream. My back and feet appreciate the seat. At least until I have to walk home again. And go to work tomorrow. Repeat ad infinitum, would it be it? Fuck. My thoughts are interrupted by an odd, looming sense of familiarity. Something's weird. Off. My thoughts are pushed back as the barista appears with my drink. There was some words there.
And here's your coffee, sir.
She stops mid-greeting as I physically recoil in surprise. No goddamn way.
Howie?
Sayori? We both stare at each other, frozen.
What are you?
I thought you.
Howie!
I stand up and hug my childhood friend. She reciprocates, squeezing me tightly. It's been years since I just enjoy the moment. After a minute, we release each other.
It's so good to see you again!
You have no idea. She wipes her eyes and takes the seat opposite me. Aren't you?
I'll be fine, silly. Not many people come here at this time anyway. If someone makes an order, though, I'll have to go. I'm sure this is technically my break. So yeah, I got time.
All right, if you're sure. What's been up with you?
Not really much. I've been working here for the past year or so. It's really nice.
Is it, though? God, I need to get an attitude check. I meet my childhood friend for the first time in years, and this is what I say? Either way, she smiles and blushes.
No, not really. But it pays the bills, you know?
Boy, do I. Yeah.
So, I guess I want to know. You're back? Permanently?
Well, for now, yeah. Finished my schooling and now I'm back here.
Yay! We can hang out like we used to!
like we used to. That phrase hit me like a truck. I remember all of it. Walking to school with her, the literature club, the festival. A flood of memories come rushing back. Not all of them are good. I wonder how they're all doing, if they're still around. That would actually be nice, yeah. We could catch up properly. Speaking of the old days, have you talked to anyone from the club? Siori's smile falls.
I talk to Monica sometimes on Twitter. As far as the other two, no. Not since, well, you know.
An awkward, painful silence ensues between us. On one hand, I don't want to stir the pot or bring up anything that shouldn't be brought up. On the other hand, now I want to talk to them again. See them again. I have a purpose, a reason to get out of bed, beyond working. An idea festers in my mind. And before I can even properly develop it, I find myself talking. I had a thought, actually. You want to be part of a little secret project? I could practically see her confusion. Why did I describe it like that, dumbass?
Well, that depends, I guess.
What if we got the gang back together? The literature club. Hang out and catch up like you and I.
Ellie, are you sure that's a good idea? After what happened?
Sierra, it's been half a decade. I don't care about what happened back then. And I doubt they will either. I sigh. I want to see my friends again. You, Monica, Natsuki, Yuri. I want to write poems, drink tea, and read books that I don't understand half the vocabulary of. I know it didn't last very long at all, but I loved what we all had. I want to bring that back. Because it sure beats sitting in my room on the weekend doing fuck all. You in? Sarah's expression hasn't changed.
Holly, this is something I'll need to think about. I don't know if I... They might still be...
They won't be, Sayori. You know how long it's been. In fact, let me ask you something. I lean forward in my chair, sipping on a lukewarm coffee. Do you still care about what happened? Sayori falters in her response.
I mean, not really, no. It was just a petty argument.
Exactly. There's no reason they'd feel any different. Especially not about you. I mean, you probably had the least involvement in it.
That's the problem, Ellie.
There was another word there that got blipped away real quick.
I wasn't.
The chime of the door interrupts her thought. A new customer.
Crap, I gotta go. Quick, here's my number.
She grabs a pen out of her apron and quickly scribbles on a piece of napkin.
I'm usually free in the evening. Just text me whenever, okay?
Okay. We briefly hug once more before her name is called.
It was great to see you.
You too, Sayori.
Coming!
I watch as she races back to the counter to prepare the next order. I look at my phone. Shit, we talked for longer than I thought. I need to get home if I have any hope of knocking out some work before bed. I nod to Sayori as I leave, but she's busy. Everyone's busy. I sigh and sip my now cold coffee. I try to have a spot of excitement about this reunion. I would be able to see them again. Assuming, of course, that they're not busy with work, family, or literally anything else of importance. And haven't moved out of the country or even the city in general. That's a fair point, actually. Who would pay airfare or gas for a literature club meetup? Hell, didn't Monica say she wanted to go to America at some point? I don't remember. Maybe they're not even alive. Died in some sort of freak accident. Thanks for that, brain, dickhead. I toss my empty coffee cup in the trash bin as I reach my apartment building. I head into the lobby towards the elevator. The elevator is still out of order. Incredible. So much for the landlord getting it fixed today. I groan and make my way to the stairs. In reality, this is all a big stretch. Even if they were here, would they even want to do this? Is it worth the trouble? Probably not, but I'm nothing if not a master of bad decisions. Just look at my degree. Absolutely fucking useless. Just like yours truly. Finally, I reach my apartment door and head inside. Those stairs might actually be the literal bane of my existence. As tired as I am, I manage to power through some chores. The excitement about the meetup is enough to make my tasks a little more bearable. I stop short at unpacking, though. I'll do that another time. I say to myself for probably the 1,000th time this week. I can only put it off for so long. Screw it, I'm tired. Before I sleep, I shoot a text to Sayori. I'll read a response if there is one when I wake up. Hopefully she gave me the right number. I toss my phone aside and collapse onto my bed. Fuck Thursday! It's Friday now! I rummage through my clothes, trying to find something half-decent. Ideally without stains or holes in it. I've really been meaning to get some new shirts and such. But I have little reason to wear them, really. Not like I go out anywhere with any sort of regularity. I dig out a clean, sky-blue shirt. It works. Sayori agreed for a few drinks down at a local sake place tonight. I've been there a couple of times after work. It's a nice bar. Quiet and boring most nights, just how I like it. We've been texting back and forth for the past few days, mostly just catching up and such. It's been only slightly awkward. I adjust my jeans and throw my hoodie on. As much as I'd love to drown my sorrows, I can't break the bank. But I have enough for a couple of drinks. I can't believe I'm actually excited to be going someplace. It's definitely a new feeling, given the last few months. Try not to fuck it up, Hallie. With that, I grab my phone and practically rush out the door. Well, here I am. To my dismay, even from outside, I can tell the place is packed. I should have figured, given it's a Friday night. I hear the pulse of drums from within. That's why. Live band tonight. So much for quiet and boring. Regardless, I head straight in. Despite the bar being full to the brim with students and salarymen, it's not difficult to find Sayori. She's sequestered herself in a corner table, away from the majority of people. But even her hiding spot can't mask her salmon-colored hair, which is a lot longer than I remember. Seems like she grew it out. She spots me almost immediately, waving and moving her way through the crowd. She's saying something, but I can't make out what it is over the rattle of conversations in the band. I point over to the bar and she nods, slinking out of her seat to join me.
Hey!
I can still barely hear her. Say again.
Hi, Allie!
Oh, hey. We're basically yelling at each other over the racket. So, drinks? My round!
I'll pay for my own, don't worry about it!
You sure? Because I can cover the cost. No, I can't.
I'm sure, we'll meet up outside!
I managed to flag down a bartender and grab my soon-to-be-usual, a whiskey highball. Cheap, and we'll do the trick. I head back outside. It's another cool night. After the week that I've had, I'll take any opportunity to sit my ass down. With most of everyone inside for the band, it's much quieter out here. I'm joined by Sayori, having just picked up a highball of her own. Lime flavor? Damn, wish I got that. Seems like we've got the same taste in alcohol.
It's cheap.
You can say that again. We awkwardly clink our cans together, open them, and take a sip. Christ, that's nasty. Maybe I should take a look at the flavored ones.
So how was your week?
Same old. Some business suit pet or pitched a fit over just pitched a fit over a discount. I cleaned up baby vomit again.
I take it that happens a lot?
The less you ask, the better. Sayori laughs.
Oh, sorry, that's terrible. Really, really terrible.
Her attempt at holding back a grin falters. I don't imagine it gets better in the bistro.
No, not really. You'd think with the world as it is today, people would have something more important to get angry about. Something worth their rage and time. But instead, they get pissed over coffee. Stuff like, Sayori, this is a dark roast, not a summer roast. Sayori, that's not how you use the grinder. Sayori, where's my donut? It's a nightmare sometimes.
Jesus, I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. It's not like you control every customer who comes into the bistro. Or do you?
The less you ask, the better.
Very funny.
But Sayori, where is my donut?
You ass.
She playfully slugs my shoulder and laughs. This is actually really nice. I realize how much I've missed her. How much I've missed them. It strengthens my resolve to bring it up sooner rather than later. That or I'm a lightweight and I'm getting drunk already. Like that's a bad thing. I take another sip of my god-awful drink. Doesn't taste so bad now. Sayori takes a sip from hers as well. No time like the present. Here we go. Hey, Sayori. About what I brought up on Wednesday. Have you thought about it at all? Sayori goes quiet for a moment, focusing her gaze to the neon-soaked street. She leans against the banister.
I have, I guess. It's complicated. I feel like it's not a good idea, you know? Burning up something that's been left to dust. Something that still stings enough to hurt even years later.
Sayori.
But the more I think about it, I do actually miss the literature club. I miss Natsuki's manga and Yuri's weird books. I miss Monica challenging us every day to come up with a poem. I miss I miss sharing our poems and being creative with them. But most importantly, I miss having friends.
Yeah. Yeah, I do too. I rub her arm sympathetically. But hey, we have each other now. I'm not going anywhere anytime soon.
Yeah.
Siri sighs and gazes down at her drink. She raises it up and finishes it in one go.
Let's do it.
Wait, you're serious?
If you are, what else am I going to do? Sit at home and feed my cat all day?
You have a cat? Why am I not surprised?
He's adorable! Remind me to show you some pictures sometime. But for the moment, how do you want to do this?
I pause. Truth be told, I haven't really thought this far ahead. Classic. Honestly, this whole idea was a spur-of-the-moment decision. I haven't really had time to think out the logistics. Well, I suppose getting into contact with everyone is step one.
You think?
Shush, you. I don't have their numbers anymore, so...
Really? Not even...
Oh. We get to pick who we might have been closer to back then. Yuri and I, I know Natsuki and I are close. We should talk about that. Well, Yuri's my girl, so I gotta go with this one, obviously. We just didn't talk after the big argument. I assumed she just broke things off.
She ghosted me too. I guess she figured I'd want to side with Natsuki. Which is stupid, they were both wrong.
And
wait. Broke things off? So you two were a couple?
I mean, kind of. We had a sort of moment when she came over that day before the festival.
Gross. I don't want details on your sex life.
Jesus, Sayori, nothing like that.
Oh, I know. I was just teasing you, silly. Yuri would have gotten all weird about it if you two did. Monica and I always had our suspicions, you know. You did spend a lot of time awkwardly close to each other reading out of the same book. Even though you both had copies of it. It wasn't exactly a secret.
Okay there, Holmes. Anyway, yeah, we kind of had a thing going on. It wasn't really a proper relationship, but it's not like I'll know now.
Oh.
Siri looks away.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's in the past. We stay quiet for a few minutes. The conversational mood we had spiraled down fast. No, the conversational mood we had spiraled down fast. Yeah, there we go. I just don't know what to say to alleviate it. Thankfully, Sayori breaks the silence by rattling her empty can.
I'm gonna go for another drink. Want one? My treat.
You don't need to spend money on me. I'll get my own.
If you're sure.
I am, but thank you. We both head back inside, being quickly enveloped by the harsh noise. I shove through a few groups of people to reach the bar and order myself another highball. Peach flavored this time. Siri does the same, but the other bartender asks her something. She puts her hand on her forehead for a moment before pulling her wallet out of her bag. You're shitting me. She got carded. I chuckle to myself and head outside once more. I mean, she doesn't look that old. She meets me after a few moments, cracking open her drink.
Sorry about that.
Underage drinking is a serious crime, you know.
Oh, shut up. Not my fault that I look like a teenager still. They even had to double-check my birthday.
June 9th, right?
You got it.
Phew, remembered that much at least.
And yours was on Valentine's Day.
Gosh, that's the day people are incepted, not the day they're born. Yup.
I guess that fits you pretty well.
Because I'm such a Casanova?
No, not like that. I mean, I don't know your love life and all that. I meant that it's just a holiday a lot of people know. I know they celebrate it over in America mostly, but people know the date more or less. So I've always remembered your birthday that way.
You remember my birthday because people in America celebrate a holiday.
Well, yeah. I always liked the concept. Letting people know you care about them is important.
I guess, but it just seems so exploitative. It's just silly to me. It's like some sort of dumb statement. Here is how much I love you in this many dollars. Do people actually buy into that?
With opinions like those, I'm sure you're a real hit with the ladies, Hallie.
Oh, shush. I'll have you know I had my fair share of dates in college.
Mm-hmm. Which is why you have so many clings to your arm right now, Mr. Casanova.
I put my hand over my chest. Ow, my feelings. She gives me the finger, smiling.
Seriously, though, I do agree with you. Something as simple and human as love shouldn't just be packaged and sold, you know? Oh, I bet that a lot of people think the same way. Not everyone places so much value on material things, after all.
Oh, people say they do. Then they buy the newest phone 6 months after the previous one. It's all just fucked. I raise my can. A toast to reckless commercialism.
Sure, I'll drink to that.
Sierra takes another swig of her drink. I take another sip of mine. This isn't bad at all. Wait, how long have we been chatting? Time to focus things back around. So, about the meeting.
Oh, right. I got distracted.
She got distracted? I literally just went on a barely coherent quasi-political tangent. Anyway, you said you were still in contact with Monica?
I wouldn't say we talk very often, but I do follow her on Twitter.
That's a start, at least. Maybe she knows where the other two went?
I don't know. Natsuki was really angry at Monica, too.
Damn it. That sounds like Natsuki, alright. Angry at everyone but herself. That's not really fair to her, but then again, she wasn't fair to us. Jesus. Where did that come from? Is this what our reunion is going to be like? Just exploding into the same arguments over and over? Or even worse, deep-seated anger and regrets making her masked by polite small talk and subtle condescension? That sounds like actual torture. I don't know. Maybe this wasn't such a great idea after all. Maybe this really isn't meant to be. I sigh and finish the other half of my drink in one fell swoop.
Everything okay?
I debate lying. No.
Me neither. I'm worried. I'm afraid this will all blow up in our faces. But if not this, then what? Just go back to our jobs and occasionally talk once in a while? Drink until we forget about our lives and go home and do it all over again?
That sounds about right.
That's not how I want to live, Hallie. I'm tired of coming home to nothing.
I can't say I love the feeling either.
Yeah, I figured as much. So let's stop worrying about it and just do it.
Are you talking to me or to yourself?
Here.
She pulls out her phone and navigates to a familiar social media app.
I'll message Monica about the plan. I can give her your phone number too if you want.
Please do.
I'll tell her to message you about any problems.
Wait, why me?
She
gives a nervous smile.
I forget my phone sometimes. At home.
Sierra, are you forgetting things? I'm very surprised. This is my surprise face.
Hallie, that's mean. You're more available than I am anyway.
I begin to mutter under my breath. And more responsible, it seems.
I heard that, you asshole.
She giggles as she taps her phone at lightning speed.
So where should we meet? And when?
Oh no. The location. Well, probably a public place to start. It's somewhere familiar so we're not stressed out too much. And preferably with copious amounts of alcohol, in case things go awry.
You could've just said here.
Figured you'd get the hint sooner or later. Sierra glances towards the loud bar and then back to me.
You serious?
Okay, I frequent this place, alright? It's not usually this loud. Usually. If you catch the right night.
Come on, Hallie. You really think Yuri would be able to handle this? Hell, I can barely hear myself thinking there.
You do have a point. Could be somewhere more mellow. Like the bistro? As long as you're not on shift, of course.
I suppose that could work. Would work. I could use my discount, too. I'm usually off on Sundays and Mondays.
Oh, that works out nicely. I only work Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday myself. Sierra stops and blinks.
You only work 4 days a week?
Yeah, but longer hours per day. 9 or 10 usually, sometimes more on Saturdays.
Oh, that's awful!
Yeah, it isn't fun. Actual torture aside, the bistro sounds good. I'd hate to drag you into your workplace on an off day, though.
I can deal with it. Maybe less so if I run into my boss, but... thankfully, she's off on Sundays.
Seems like Sunday is the golden day, then.
That works for me. Hopefully it does for them, too.
Sierra sips her drink. Would this upcoming Sunday work? She starts sputtering, having accidentally swallowed the rest of her drink in her moment of surprise.
Seriously? That's like a day's notice, Hallie! No, it'd be next Sunday at the soonest.
Alright. That gives us plenty of time to get in touch and plan things, I suppose. If we can get in touch, that is. And if Monica will even be up for it.
I guess.
Sierra looks crestfallen. Damn it. Weren't you being all confident earlier with this whole thing?
Yeah, I just...
She sighs.
Doubt just keeps clinging to me no matter what I say or do. Like it'll all go horribly wrong anyway.
Hey, look. I don't mean to say that this will definitely go to shit. It's just probably will go to shit.
How reassuring.
I'm just joking. It'll go fine, I'm sure.
Are you?
Not in the slightest. But we'll do our best. And that's all we really can do, isn't it? Siori is silent for a moment. She leans closer to me, rubbing my arm affectionately. I'm glad she's here. We sit in a silence for a while, looking out into the street. The night has gotten pretty cold. I should have packed a jacket. After a bit, Siori turns to me.
Thank you, Holly.
Oh, something happened to your the end of your hair there, dear. Something wrong with the MPT, maybe?
For taking me out tonight and planning this. I'm sorry for always being a downer. Being constantly worried.
You're not always a downer. And it's okay to be worried. Who wouldn't be? But I think the important thing is that we're having a good time. This is fun.
It is for me, too.
We stand up and hug under the bar's awning. The crowd for the band has slowly been dispersing. Seems like they're done with the receipt. They're set. Ah, damn it. Speaking of, I have to start heading home. Sorry to cut things short.
Yeah, I was about to say, I need to get going myself. Work.
Same here. Another week at the grind. Plus, I can just about feel that second drink coming on now. But hey, at least we can do this anytime you want. And I'll stop by for a coffee after our work tomorrow. How's that?
That would be great. You need a cab or something?
Nah, I don't live too far away. I was fine enough walking here.
Alright. See you tomorrow.
You too. I toss my can into this trash and start my way home. Before I round the corner, I look back at the bar. Siori hasn't moved from her seat. It's admittedly tough to tell from the distance, but her mood appears forlorn. I know she struggles, or at least struggled with some of the same issues that I do. It's not like I'll ever forget that Saturday before the festival. I figure the alcohol probably isn't doing her any favors either. Nor any for me, for that matter. Social events are really just temporary, aren't they? After a brief moment of brevity from the stress of life, it's all over. Back to the grind, again. Always just looking forward to the precious few hours during the week where we can actually act like human beings. Where we have purpose and desires beyond feeding a corporate machine. What a wonderful fucking world. Seems like the alcohol is affecting me already. I sound like some whiny college student. Yes, you do. I'll ask her how she's feeling tomorrow. Right now, I just have a pulsing headache. I manage to scale the fucking stairs and get to my apartment. I don't even lock my door or change my clothes. I should probably do that. But that sounds like a problem for the Hallie of tomorrow to worry about. Tonight was fun. Really fun. I'm glad I got to see Sayori again. I can only hope that meeting the rest of the literature club will go so well. Yeah, I can only hope. I manage to drink some water and head to my bedroom. My brain is swimming in pure whiskey at this point. I at least make sure my alarm is set before passing out on my bed. That's all for now. We hope you enjoyed the demo. It's interesting so far. A couple things I might contend it for, but since this was a short demo anyway, let's head back to those choices and pick the rest of them. How's that? We'll just skip right to it. Skip. There we go. Oh, crap. Can I, how do I get the save menu? Escape key, save me. There we go. Huzzah. Okay. So last time, we picked Yuri. I know Natsuki and I were close. I guess she assumed I took Yuri's side or something. She never talked to me again.
I think I spoke to her once after. Well, you know, she was still really mad, even at me. It was the whole thing. You remember Mr. Ikamachi?
English? Yeah, I remember.
He had to come and break it up.
Holy shit. She started a proper fight?
No, she just shouted. A lot. I'm surprised you didn't hear about it.
I wasn't exactly Mr. Popular. Always heard about things late. I didn't hear about a fight in that room, though. Can't believe that was you. Oh, did I say I did? I did hear about a fight in that room. Okay.
Jern almost came the blues. You know how she can get.
Boy, do I.
Do you? You two were dating, weren't you?
Dating is a bit of a stretch. I mean, there was this one point where I think we both thought something was going to happen, but it never did.
Oh.
Siri looks down at her empty drink.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's in the past. We stay quiet for a few minutes. All right, we're back to the skip thing, so let's load up and see what the other conversation had to offer. We should talk about that. I didn't know you switched to a different phone.
Well, you would've if you had, you know, talked to me.
Ouch. I knew this was going to be brought up sooner or later. I might as well try to patch this up now. Honestly, I should have. I just figured that, well, after what happened at the festival, getting together wasn't a priority for either of us. I couldn't handle a relationship then, not after what happened. And even when I moved past the incident, it felt kind of awkward to just, like, come out of the blue and just start chatting you up again. I know this is sounding like I'm making excuses. I'm not. To be honest, I didn't want to own up and say that I fucked up. I assumed you were mad at me for essentially ghosting you, and having someone else at my house the day prior.
I kind of was, truthfully. Though not at you having friends, silly. But at the ghosting, yeah, I was. It was just... You comforted me, told me things were going to be okay, and then just left. My mother badgered me for weeks over why I didn't have you over anymore. I really just didn't want to see your face again. You said you loved me, and then you were gone. And before I knew it, I was helping you leave for university. I hated that day, you know? I only did it because Mom asked me to.
I know.
But now, seeing things as they were, I understand why you did what you did.
For what it's worth, I'm really, really sorry. I shouldn't have done that to you. She shrugs and focuses her gaze to the street.
Don't be. It's in the past.
Alright, so I suppose that's truly it for this demo and what it has to offer. Well, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I don't know when this project is going to be getting done. They seem to be working off and on with it for alongside Exit Music Redux. But, you know, it gets there when it gets there. And that's all for now. So, yeah, we'll catch you next time with another mod. See you then.